So we're going to have a little bit of fun with Linux today because I just upgraded to openSUSE Leap 15.4 that just came out. I think it was today or yesterday. I can't remember it. Made a video about that. You should be watching. And we are running, what version is it? We are running 4.6.5, I think it is, of Cinnamon. And there will be people out there that really, really, really want the latest and greatest. And openSUSE kind of have this openSUSE software here, where you can go in here and you can search a package. It can be the kernel, it can be whatever you want. You click search, and then you get a page like this here. And there's other ways of interacting with this. You can do it via the command line by a program called OPI or OBI. I can't remember right now. I have a video about that. But you can see down here that in Tumbleweed, they have 5.0. And in Leap 5.3, they have 4.64. This is probably not being updated yet because, like I said, 5.15 just got released. So there's no official release in here yet, but it will then be 4.6.5. But if you click here and show community packages, if there's someone in the community having a repo with the software that you're searching for, you can see it in here. And there is someone that has it here in that's called 5.0 or have version 5.0 that should be supporting openSUSE Leap 5.14 that we are running right now. So think of this, like I said, with as Ubuntu PPAs or the AUR of Arch or backporting with Debian. But just like anything else, this is a community repository, so the quality can be really, really varying. You know, some people are really good at it. They test the packages. They test the install processes so it works 100%. Some people just test that it's actually being built, you know, that the packages are being, you know, the RPM packages are being made without any errors, and that's good enough for them. So use this at your own risk, okay? This is not guaranteed to work, but in most cases it works. Again, with the AUR, most of them work. Sometimes they don't work. PPAs, most of the time it works. Sometimes it don't work, and so on and so on. So only use, I would say only use this, you know, software here, openSUSE software or PPAs or any third-party repositories if you really have to. We are going to basically install Cinnamon 5.0 onto openSUSE Leap. So we click here, export download. And if you click down here, you get like a, what is it, YMP file. And I think if you're under Firefox, it will automatically download and open it with Yast. You can also add the repository manually. So what you can do here is that you can actually right-click and you can save link as. It will then save this link here, this YMP file here, and you can actually open that with the software center. So let's try and save it here. And if you go in here and we go into download, where are you? There you are. We can actually here open with Yast one-click install. So if I click on that one right now, it will open up the Yast software tool. It will add the repository to the repository list, and it will install the Cinnamon desktop. But I know how much you guys like to run the command line. So we're going to do this down here. We're going to do it the hard way. So let's open up a good old terminalski here. Let's put it up here. And we need to do all of these in root. So I think I'll just use this here. So we just root all the time. So let's add the repository. So right click, copy, and middle mouse button, and it has added it here. I kind of like the text output that it's giving us here. We need to refresh it. Refresh it. And it's do you want to trust this repository? It's importing the key now and ask us if we want to trust it. So we have trust temporarily or trust always. Do you want to reject the key? R, I think, is reject. If you click R, that's the default, is you reject the key. T, I think, is trusting temporarily. And A is you know, trusting it always. And we want to keep this repository, we want to use it, so we are going to trust it always. And we got some invalid things here. Valid metadata not found for specific URL. Okay, now it works. Sometimes you need to run the refresh more than once, because, like I said, openSUSE leaked. Either it came out like a couple of hours ago or yesterday, so this is still kind of new. If you get refresh error on any operating system, or meaning any Linux distribution, sorry, if you get a refresh error on Ubuntu, Debian, Arch, and stuff like that, like, oh my god, I couldn't refresh this repository, it could be because it's overloaded or something, you know, maybe your network is having a hiccup. So try and run one or two times after that to see if it fixes it. And most of the times, you just need to do it one more time. So that's why I'm doing it. Never be like, oh my god, I got a repository refresh error. Oh my god, it's not working anymore. It could just be a minor little mistake, or, you know, a package got dropped via the connection or something, you know, Kremlings. You know, it's Monday, some things just don't work. So let's go and install it here. So, well, Cinnamon Desktop, loading repositories, reading refresh. Cinnamon Desktop, not find the package names. So providing this is already installed. So we have it all, because I am running Tumbleweed with the I'm running openSUSE Leap with Cinnamon already installed. So what happens if we do an update? So it is going to update Cinnamon. What happens if I do a dub? Okay, nothing. So this openSUSE Leap has two updating methods. It has UP, that's a normal updating way, and then it has DUP, that's basically a distribution upgrade. So you use DUP if you're going from 15.3 to 15.4 and so on and so on. Most, all the time, not most, but 99.9% of the time, you under Leap, you do Zipper UP, or Cypher, however you will pronounce it, UP. Under Tumbleweed, you do it DUP. That's how it is. So let's see what happened if we just do a UP update here, a normal update. Okay, so it's saying they're not going to install. So that's because we need to enable, we need to go in here and we need to go down to the, here is his repository. So you can do either, you can prioritize. So if you set a lower, like to 98, that means prioritize software within this repository. So I'm going to do that first also and see if that helps, or we can do something else. Okay, they're not going to be installed. Something else you can do is you go into the software center here. You can also do this via the command line, but this is just a little bit more virtual, and I can't remember the, I think it's like zipper update from, and then the repository name PSK, you know, the repository name. So it's like zipper UP from, and then the repository name. I think it's something to that day. I don't know if the syntax is 100% correct, but you can actually force zipper to update from a specific repository. But it's actually, you can also via the command line set zipper or cypher, however the fuck you pronounce it, to change vendor settings. And that's what I'm going to do, but it's a little bit more virtual if I do it in here. So if you go in here, we show repositories, and we go down here to the PK Russell Zone project. Switch system packages to the versions in this repository. So what we are telling Leap here is that, or openSUSE here, is that always use the packages from in here. So what it's going to do here, it's like, okay, deinstall this. Yeah, we want to deinstall this here. Okay, try again. So now we can see now it's going to update it. So if I do this down here, oh, it's already logged in. So if I close this one, oh, well, that I don't want to abandon the changes. But if I ran Zipper or Cypher UP, it will now upgrade from in here because we have switched to the system packages in there. You know, vendor pack. We're basically saying to openSUSE is that prioritize, like I said, packages from this repository. But we're just going to use the graphical way for updating it here in here. And it's just because I can't remember the commands for it on the Zipper. if you go in here and we do SIP or help, you can see we can find all the commands in here. Yeah, there are so many options in here. And I don't want to bore you guys with me finding the right commands. You can do that yourself. I am a guy of least resistance path. So if this don't work right out of the bat and I can't remember it out of my head and I'm too lazy to Google it, I just use something that is faster than me Googling the right command. So we're just going to use this one here. We're clicking continue. And it's going to download. And basically what it should be doing here theoretically, and I don't know if this is going to work, is that it's going to basically download and upgrade my Cinnamon desktop to 5.0 from 4.6.5. So when this is done installing, we will go and reboot together to see if we're actually going to reboot into 5.4.0. Okay, so now it's finished and it's set to say installation successfully finished, and you get a summary here, and we just want to click finished and close this terminal, close everything down here, blop blop blop, and let's basically just restart this sucker here. Let's see if it works. Are we running the latest version then? Oh, we are on 5.2.2. So yeah, this seems to be working. It seems to be chef kiss perfection. So we basically are running now the latest and greatest Cinnamon desktop under OpenSUSE Leap 15.4. But yeah, I think I will keep this up and running and see how long it takes till it breaks. But I'm actually really surprised because I did this with the release candidate and it botched up my system. The OpenSUSE Software Center, think of it like the AUR on the arts. See you all later. Bye-bye.